Interiors and exteriors often contain such elements as decorative ledges, belt courses on building facades, skirting boards, splays, and picture frame moldings on walls. Sweep modifier does an excellent job of creating such architectural elements. I guess you're already familiar with, or at least you've heard, of a plugin called Sweep Pro that significantly expands the functionality of Sweep Modifier. Sweep Pro makes creating architectural elements as simple and convenient as possible, allowing us to create an organized library of profiles. Sweep Pro comes with a default set of profiles, and if you wish, you can always expand your library with some new sets from Kstudio website, which presents a constantly growing collection of profiles for visualizing interiors and exteriors. Using this plugin, you can also build your own user libraries with the profiles created for specific projects. In my experience, all those efforts put into creating user profiles tend to simply go to waste, because in the end, they remain to gather dust inside the parent scenes. Sweep Pro gives these profiles a chance for a new life in new projects. Creating your own library is very convenient and doesn't require any complex manipulations. Simply select a profile and click the Add to Library button. That's it! The profile is now in your library. The plugin also creates preview thumbnails displaying the sizes on the go. Unlike the standard modifier, Sweep Pro allows you to control the dimensions of the profile cross-section. It is amazingly convenient. Let's take a closer look at the plugin's functionality. Installing the plugin is simple. Just drag and drop the installer into the 3ds Max window. Confirm the license agreement and click Next. This will start the registration application. Generate an ID file. Go to your account on the Kstudio website and use the file to get a license key. The key is generated immediately. Then just a few simple steps remain. Use the 3ds Max menu Customize interface to find a Kstudio category. In the category, find the Sweep Pro plugin and start using it. At the beginning, you will be provided with several default profiles. You can also purchase more profile libraries on the Kstudio website. These too are installed by dragging and dropping into the 3ds Max window. Now I am going to install all the profiles one by one, and we'll see how the plugin displays them. So, here we see new sections with additional profiles. You can navigate the directories by switching between the folders where the profiles had been installed. The plugin also allows adding profiles to favorites. You can do this either by clicking on the star symbol on the selected profile, or by using the button on the toolbar. In order to view your favorite profiles, just click on the Favorites button. Here you can see all the starred profiles in one window, which is very convenient when preparing for a specific project. You can adjust your preview thumbnails by increasing or decreasing their size. Sorting options are also available either by file name, width, height, or aspect ratio. Here, for example, I've applied sorting from high and narrow profiles to square and flat ones. The functionality of the plugin allows assigning a profile to a spline immediately by simply double-clicking on the profile of your choice. Next, you can adjust the rest of the parameters, such as path segmentation, that is to say, molding detailing along the length, and molding cross-sectional detailing. Here, you can also adjust the smooth parameter that allows smoothing both the profile and the path. You can use pivot alignment to adjust the position of the profile relative to the path. Another feature, and probably the most interesting one, is the ability to resize the cross-section of the profile. You can do this either maintaining the set proportions or changing the length and width of the profile separately. All the changes take effect on the fly, interactive and clear. Just double-click back on the profile you need to apply. And then again, you can continue editing the grid density for both the path and the profile. You can then switch to any ready-made profile and continue editing it. Just select it and choose a new profile. However, the user models are not always easy to use. Some models can't be used this way at all. A better option is to transfer such profiles to Sweep Pro. In order to do this, I extract the profile via the Extract option and name it. Now, I can immediately add it to the profile library, which is also done very easily. First, of course, I'll need to create a directory for the files, so that they don't get lost and can be later used in other projects. Add directory option and paste the path into the dialog box. That's it! The directory has now been created and stored by the plugin. Next step is to click the Add to Library button. A new dialog box appears, and here I can customize the preview for my new profile. Here I can also change the position of the profile, but in this case I had everything right from the start. So now we can press the render button, and the plugin renders the image and displays the dimensions. You can see these files appear in my new directory. If you visit our website, you can also purchase some other profiles for modeling skirting boards, moldings and ledges. You can find the link to the shop in the description to this video. Have a nice day!